Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to enhance your photos by adding falling snow to scenes that already have snow on the ground. For your convenience, I provided this photo that you can download. You can find the link in my video's description or project files. Alternatively, you could use any winter photo you'd like that doesn't show actively falling snow. Just ensure its resolution is 72 pixels per inch. To check it, go to Image and Image Size. If the resolution isn't 72 pixels per inch, simply update it and adjust the size as needed. Make a new layer by clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but before we do, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard. If the colors are reversed, press X. Since our foreground color is black, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill our empty layer with the foreground color. Let's convert this layer into a smart object so we can add filters to it that we can adjust at any time. Click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Noise, and add Noise. Make the amount 25%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. I'll make the angle minus 60 degrees. This will determine the angle of the falling snow. Make the distance 3 pixels. To save a little space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the smart filters. Change its blend mode to Screen. Make a new layer and fill it with black. Then go to Filter and click Add Noise. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Ensure the chain link icon is active between the width and height fields. This links them together. Enter 300% in either the width or height field. Since this resized layer now extends beyond the visible canvas, it increases the document's file size. To crop off the excess, press Ctrl or Command A to select the entire document and go to Image and Crop. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Convert this layer into a smart object. Go to Filter, Pixelate, and Crystallize. Make the cell size 6. This does three things to our snowflakes. It will enlarge them, give them irregular multifaceted shapes, and vary their translucency. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the distance 10 pixels. Collapse the smart filters and change the blend mode to Screen. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. It's important to note that adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. If we want an adjustment layer to affect just the one layer below it, we'll need to make the adjustment layer into a clipping mask. To do this, simply click the clipping mask icon or go to Layer and create clipping mask. Make the white input level 30 and the black input level 190. Make a new layer, fill it with black, and convert it into a smart object. Go to Filter and click Add Noise. Click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter and click Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.4 pixels. Click Filter again and Crystallize. Make the cell size 20. click the adjustment layer icon and select Levels. Clip it to the layer beneath it. Set the input white level to 82 and the input black level to 84. Make layer 3 active and convert it into a smart object. Open the Transform tool and at the top type in 300% in either the width or the height. Then press Enter or Return twice. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Set the radius to 6 pixels. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Set the distance to 40 pixels. Reposition it until you're happy with the snowflake formations. You can always readjust it later. Change its blend mode to screen. Let's collapse the smart filters. Make a copy of the layer and reduce its opacity to 50%. Before repositioning the layer, make sure Auto Select is unchecked. This will avoid unintentionally activating other layers when we click on our document. Reposition the duplicated snowflake layer. If you want to angle it, open the Transform tool. You may see a message notifying you that smart filters will be temporarily disabled while using the Transform tool. Just click OK. Press Ctrl or Command 0 to see the transform's entire bounding box. Go outside the bounding box, and when the cursor changes into a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return twice. To zoom back in, press Ctrl or Command 0 again. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.